Well, I see you've already made yourself comfortable. Don't need to ask you twice. Fine with me. Always like when you come to visit, as I'm sure you know. How many times have I said that so far? Yeah, I lost count about eight. You know what that means, don't you? It means it must be true. I'm tired. It's one of those nice feelings you get after a long day of this stuff. You ever get that? It's like satisfaction. Just knowing you, I don't know, the feeling of. Just the feeling of having used. I don't know what I'm saying. Oh, you know? Have I told you that I'm glad that you came to visit? Oh, my bad. No. I'm a little nervous, actually. I'm just being facetious. Well, I wanted to talk to you about something. No, it's not bad. It's probably good. Well, I hope it's good. No, I'm not proposing either. So don't worry about that. You remember when we met? All the silly things both of us said. I bet we'd cringe to scroll through those conversations. Don't you think? Yeah. But we've been together a while. And I don't know. I really like going on adventures with you. And of course, that's like my livelihood, is adventure. Whatever it happens to be. The adventures of going over to visit you and seeing where you live. Just quite a different place than where I live, for sure. And we've met each other's families and all the strange interactions that leads to. We've had fun. It's been fun with you. But I know. The dreaded but. Well, I've told you before that I don't do well in long distance relationships. I mean, I said that from the get-go. No, don't worry. I told you it's not bad. It has been challenging for that reason. And that's probably why I keep telling you, by the way, that I'm still very happy you came to visit. I just love you so much better in proximity. It's where the life is. But that's what I wanted to talk to you about. I know your situation is pretty, like, specific. And I'm pretty cozy in what I'm doing here. Like, I'm in no current danger of anything. So I was wondering if, you know, if maybe you'd like to come be with me here for a time. You know, not just visiting, like if you came and moved in with me. I don't expect an answer right now. I don't want you to, because I don't think it's wise to just to go with it. I mean, maybe you're like me, and maybe you'll just kind of throw caution to the wind, and, you know, it's an adventure. I like adventures. I won't look down on you for that, but I also respect that this is a big decision, and I want you to do what makes you happy. And I mean that. I mean, it is challenging to be in a long distance relationship, but sometimes you meet people. Sometimes I meet people who might just be worth that challenge. So, something to think about. Of course, we can work out the details later if it's something that you think would be fun. I think it would be fun. I do. I do. I think it would be fantastic. I've already dreamed about it a lot. And they're good dreams. They're exciting dreams. You see us together. And we don't have to stay here. I mean, I'm here for a few more months before my lease is up. But then we could do whatever. We don't even have to stay here in the city. We could go somewhere else. I don't care. I'm not attached to this place. In a way, it's even more of an adventure to go somewhere new together. Because I think it sounds really freaking fun to be somewhere with you that neither of us have ever been, and to just explore. I mean, what an adventure, right? I need to come up with a new word, but I like adventure too. It's a fun word. I mean, how exciting, right? Everything is new to both of us. It's like we're in the same situation. I mean, if you come here and we stay here, it's like I kind of know the area. I've got a feel for what's around here and what we can do. And that's fun in its own respects, you know? But it's different than us being somewhere new to both of us. Because then we're on equal footing. Then we both have no idea of anything that's anywhere. And that's kind of cute. It's, I don't know. It's interesting. I think there's some kind of romantic connotation to this idea of a shared struggle. Like if we both moved somewhere and we're like struggling to pay bills or something, you know, living paycheck by paycheck, and there's like a weird romantic notion around that, like just trying to make ends meet, and this couple who were fighting the world. But I don't, to be honest, I don't see that with you. Like, I don't see us struggling. It's not that I don't see us being romantic, that's not what I mean by that. It's like I don't see us having troubles. I see things more working out. I mean, what are the chances of us being here right now? That's kind of weird, right? I mean, before I was just some crazy guy on the internet, and now I'm your crazy guy on the internet. And you're one of those people that make my life fun. I need those kind of people. I need you. This is my admission of devotion, so to speak. I'm trying to be real. I'm trying not to be so crazy for a minute. So hold on to that. But this is me telling you, okay, look, I'm willing to fight to make this work. Because this is something meaningful to me. You are meaningful to me. So I'm willing to do what it takes. Does that make you feel special? Oh, good. Now you know how I feel. I'm glad we can share that sentiment. You gotta admit, no matter what, no matter if you're thinking about it, I hope you're thinking about it, no matter if you're leaning towards it or not, the idea is pretty exciting, right? Maybe some people would say it's early to do that. But time is an illusion. I don't know. I mean, it's true. I don't worry about things much. It's gotten me into trouble before, but it doesn't matter. I think part of the value in life comes not from avoiding challenge, but from growing through it. So I've never been afraid to make mistakes and to do crazy things and to get myself into situations that other people might advise against. Because, like I told you, sometimes it's worth the risk. And I think you've always been worth the risk. Yeah. I'm pretty sure I've made that clear by now. If I haven't, I'm not doing a very good job as your partner. I'll do better, I swear. It's kind of fun, though. The dream is always evolving. The dream of us living together. I mean, with me, I don't have a lot of stuff. But I'm okay to take on the a communal belongings thing. I'm not saying I'm gonna take all your stuff. I'm sure you realize by now that I'm not very clingy to my things, and I'll be even less clingy to other people's things. But it's kind of fun to, when you're living with someone, to, you know, pick out new things together and to, I don't know, to create a space together, I guess. It's always interesting. And we'll have that. We'll have a weird... the weird thing to acknowledge, we'll have our own combined scent. You know how each, like, if you go to a family's house, they always have, like, they have a smell. They have a family smell. I don't know how it works. I don't know the mechanics of that, but if we live together, somehow it's gonna combine and we're gonna have a smell, a scent. Hopefully it'd be good. They're not really usually bad, I guess. Maybe sometimes. But I feel like most people scents that I've encountered are usually pretty neutral. Like, they're definitely distinct and they're different and you can tell, but I haven't found many that are immediate rejects, like, no, I don't like this. I mean, they say all that stuff about smell being so related to memory. I don't remember the details, something about the olfactory sense just really connects to memory neurologically. And it's true in the sense that, like, sometimes I'll encounter a scent and it'll be similar to like a friend's house when I was growing up. So I'll smell something and it'll trigger a bunch of these memories of being over at this friend's house. Things that I maybe haven't thought of for years. I'm getting older, decades, I can say. And that's strange, I don't know. So we could pick out our furniture. We're gonna have to get furniture. I mean, I don't know if you can bring any of yours with you. We can do that, I guess, a little bit. Whatever's convenient, or if things aren't, we can just buy stuff here or wherever we go. If we do go somewhere new, we might as well just leave everything behind, every big thing, and then just kind of start it fresh. That sounds interesting. I think we could accomplish a lot. Maybe we could be the next power couple. Maybe not Hollywood. Like, I don't know what else. I don't know who could be the next amateur power couple. That sounds kind of weird. Maybe it has to sound weird. I don't know. So we could go somewhere. We'd both have to get new jobs unless we could somehow find a way to transfer a job we already have. I don't know. It depends on where we go, I guess. We could even try to leave the country. That's an adventure for sure. You can't avoid calling that an adventure. Because international living is kind of crazy. Lots of hoops you gotta jump through. Even just travel international is kind of a headache sometimes. Fortunately, it's really expensive and I don't do that very often. That's the first time I've been grateful for something being expensive and hard to get to. I don't know. It's a happy sigh. See, I told you it wasn't bad. I mean, it could be. You could just flat out reject me, and you could be like, you know, this isn't working out. You're trying to move on too fast. I don't think it's appropriate. So I never want to see you again. Give me a Dear John text. I don't know if people do Dear John letters anymore. Since text messages these days. Been MMS with a bunch of emojis. You'll like write out, it's not you, it's me, but in emojis, however you manage that. And then I would just send back the crying emoji maybe 6 times for good measure. That's not how it works. I thought I was learning the way of the world these days. Again, I'm not trying to force you into this. I respect your autonomy and your thinking process wholeheartedly. And if you think that you want to wait, then that's cool with me. But I would like, if we don't pursue this, I would like to somehow pursue ways that we could get together more often. Can't say no to that, right? Well, I hope you wouldn't say no to that. How about that? It's the point of a relationship to be together with someone. I'm trying to make it more often. In a way, I'm trying to. Well, I'm not trying to make it permanent, I guess, because that's, well, can you do that? I don't know, I'm thinking about it too much. Yeah, thinking about things excessively is a pastime of mine. You got nothing else to do, just sitting, thinking about the world. Actually, the more you think about things, the less things make sense. But some things you don't have to think about. Some things you can just feel. And some things feel very right. You feel right. So please, think about it. But for now, I think it's a good time to sleep. I know it's your first night here, but we have a lot to do tomorrow. And it would be very wise to be rested. I've already told you, I'm not giving you any hints about what I've planned. Because I like surprises. I like sharing surprises. Okay, I like forcing surprises, whatever. Semantics. You can say whatever you want. You can threaten me. I'm not going to tell you. That's fine. Have an iron will. Ooh. Bribery is a lot better than threats. But I still can't break. I have an oath. I gave an oath to my integrity. It's very serious. Yeah, I can't break that oath. The Council of Surprisery would lose all respect for me. My license would be revoked, and I just don't know what I would do to myself after that point. I don't know what I would become. Long story short, you're just gonna have to deal. Whatever. You can handle it. You've put up with me this far. What's one more night? So dramatic. I like it. Okay, well, I will save you the torture and I'll go to bed myself. Just trust me. You'll need the rest. You'll want the rest, at least. I'm the one that knows all the juicy secrets. So you should. Aren't you tired? Well, that's very sweet, but you should be tired. You've had a long day. You seriously have had a long day. Traveling is tiring. That sounds about right. Okay. So it's settled then. We'll go to bed. And we'll wake up and we'll have an amazing day together. Can be arranged. Now you can sleep. I'll see you happily. In the morning. Oh, wait. One thing I do have to tell you. Before I forget. I'm super stoked, super happy that you're here. I'm serious. Good night.